ఎ థౌజండ్ టీచింగ్స్ ఉపదేశ సహస్రి బై శ్రీ ఆది శంకరాచార్య చాప్టర్ 16 కన్సిస్టింగ్ ఆఫ్ అర్త్ 1 ది హార్డ్ మెటీరియల్ ఇన్ ద బాడీ ఈజ్ నోన్ టు బి అ ట్రాన్స్ఫర్మేషన్ ఆఫ్ అర్త్ ద లిక్విడ్ పార్ట్ కన్సిస్ట్స్ ఆఫ్ వాటర్ అండ్ హీట్ అండ్ వైబ్రేషన్ అండ్ అపర్చర్స్ ఇన్ ద బాడీ ఆర్ డ్యూ టు ఫైర్ ఎయిర్ అండ్ ఈథర్ రెస్పెక్టివ్లీ 2 స్మెల్ ఎట్సెట్రా దట్ ఈస్ ద సెన్సెస్ అండ్ దేర్ ఆబ్జెక్ట్స్ ఆర్ ప్రొడ్యూస్డ్ ఫ్రమ్ ఎర్త్ ఎట్సెట్రా రెస్పెక్టివ్లీ యాజ్ ద సెన్సెస్ హ్యావ్ ఫర్ దేర్ ఆబ్జెక్ట్స్ థింగ్స్ ఆఫ్ దేర్ ఓన్ కైండ్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ కలర్ అండ్ లైట్ ది లేటర్ బీయింగ్ ఆఫ్ ద సేమ్ నేచర్ యాజ్ ది ఫార్మర్ ఇట్స్ ఆబ్జెక్ట్ 3 దీస్ ఆర్ కాల్డ్ ది ఆర్గాన్స్ ఆఫ్ నాలెడ్జ్ ద ల్యారింగ్స్ అండ్ ది హ్యాండ్ ఎట్సెట్రా ఆర్ కాల్డ్ ది ఆర్గాన్స్ ఆఫ్ యాక్షన్ అండ్ ద మైండ్ ద 11th విచ్ ఈజ్ విథిన్ ద బాడీ ఈజ్ ఫర్ ది పర్పస్ ఆఫ్ నోయింగ్ డిఫరెంట్ ఆబ్జెక్ట్స్ వన్ ఆఫ్టర్ అనదర్ యాజ్ ద టెండ్ టు ప్రెజెంట్ దెమ్సెల్వ్స్ అట్ ద సేమ్ టైమ్ 4 ద ఇంటెలెక్ట్ ఈజ్ ఫర్ డిటర్మైనింగ్ ఆబ్జెక్ట్స్ ఆల్వేస్ ఇల్యూమినింగ్ ద ఆల్ పర్వేసివ్ ఇంటెలెక్ట్ బై ఇట్స్ లైట్ విచ్ ఈజ్ ఇట్స్ ఓన్ నేచర్ ద సెల్ఫ్ ఈజ్ కాల్డ్ ద నోవర్ ది పర్పస్ ఆఫ్ ది అబౌవ్ 4 వర్సెస్ ఈజ్ దాట్ ద సెల్ఫ్ ఈజ్ డిఫరెంట్ ఫ్రమ్ ది బాడీ the senses, the mind, and the intellect. 5. Just as light assumes the forms of objects revealed by it, but is really different from, though apparently mixed up with them, so the self is different from the mental modifications, whose forms it assumes while revealing them. 6. The self illumines without effort the intellect in the forms of sound, etc., present before it like a stationary lamp devoid of any effort which illumines everything within its reach. 7. Pleasure, etc. qualify the intellect identifying itself with the combination of the body and the senses and illumined by the eternal light of the self. 8. For one considers oneself to be distressed by pain in the head, etc., the seer is different from the seen, that is, that which feels pain. The self is free from pain as it is the seer of the pain. 9. One becomes unhappy when one identifies oneself with the intellect which has assumed the form of unhappiness but not by merely seeing it. The witness of the pain in the body which is a combination of the limbs and the senses does not feel pain. 10. May it not be that the self is both object and subject like the eye? No. The eye consists of several parts and is a combination, but the self does not become an object as it is the seer. 11. One may argue that the self also has many qualities such as knowledge, effort and so on, and therefore like the eye, it may be both subject and object. No, it is not so. It can never be an object because like light, it has only one quality, that is knowledge. 12. Just as light, though an illuminator, does not illumine itself, so even assuming that there is a dividing line, dividing it into two categories, subject and object in the self, it cannot illumine itself, for it is a homogeneous conscious nature. 13. Nothing can be an object of its own quality, for fire does not burn or illumine itself. 14. The doctrine of the Buddhists that the intellect is perceived by itself is refuted by this. Similarly, the assumption of parts in the self is also unreasonable, for it is a homogeneous nature without having a dividing line in it. 15. The doctrine of the void is also not reasonable, as it must be accepted that the intellect is witnessed like a jar by another, that is, the self. For self exists even before the intellect comes into existence. 16. Whatever is pervaded by anything is an effect of that thing, the cause. The cause has no an existence invariably anterior to that of the effect. Itself uncaused, the cause producing effects, such as the intellect, etc., must therefore exist before them. 17. Discarding ignorance, the root of all superimposition and the controller of transmigratory existence, one should know the self to be the supreme Brahman, which is always free and devoid of fear. 18. Transmigratory existence consists of waking and dream. Their root is deep sleep, consisting of ignorance. No one of these three states has a real existence because each goes out of existence when another remains in it. One should therefore give up all these three states. 1920. Just as the closing and opening of the eyelids connected with the vital force are mistaken for the properties of the eye, which is of the nature of light, and just as motion is wrongly attributed to the mind and the intellect, which are also of the same nature, so the self, though really not an agent, is mistaken for one because actions arise when the body, the intellect and the mind, the eye, light, objects, etc. coexist with it. 21. The peculiar characteristic of the mind is reflection, and that of the intellect is determination, and not vice versa. Everything is therefore superimposed on self. 22. Organs are thought to be not all-pervading but limited by their particular appendages, which are in the body. The intellect gets identified with the organs and hence with the body. Illumining the intellect, therefore, the self appears to be of the same size as the body. 23. Objection. Both knowledge and its objects are extremely momentary, that is, perishable by nature every moment. They are appearances only, without any reality whatever, and are continuously being produced. Just as the lamp of the preceding moment appears to be the same in the succeeding moments on account of similarity, so both the objects and the subjects of the preceding and the succeeding moments wrongly appear to be identical on account of similarity. The goal of human life is the removal of this idea of the continuity in knowledge and its objects, and the removal of the indiscrimination to which it is due. 24. Reply. According to one school of these philosophers, external things are subjects of knowledge which is different from them. According to another school, external objects other than knowledge do not exist. The unreasonableness of the former school is now going to be described. 25-26. According to this school, knowledge has to be admitted to be identical with external things, and everything being momentary, and the intellect the receptacle in which the impressions of memory are to be retained, being non-existent at the time of receiving the impressions. There will always be the absence of memory. Being momentary, according to them, the intellect never retains the impressions of memory. Again, recognition is said to be due to a misconception of similarity, but there is no cause of similarity between the preceding and the succeeding moments. If, on the other hand, a witness perceiving both the moment be admitted, the doctrine of momentariness is abandoned, but that is not desirable. 27. The teaching of a man to the attainment of end, viz., the bringing to an end of the ideas of continuity in knowledge and its objects, becomes useless, for it requires no effort to be accomplished, as all phenomenon exists only for a moment. The coming to an end of the said continuity does not therefore depend on anything else. 28. If, according to you, the effect depends on the cause, though unconnected with it, you have to accept dependence on a series which is quite foreign. If you say, though all things like causes and effects are momentary, some effects depend on some fixed causes, still nothing can depend on anything else, according to your doctrine of momentariness. 29. The particular one of two things existing at the same time and connected with each other is fit to depend on the other, owing to whose connection it is benefited. 30. Our doctrine is that there is false superimposition on the self and its negation in the same self. Please tell me who will attain liberation, the result of knowledge, according to you, who hold that all, that is, both the superimposed and the substratum are annihilated. To be continued. ओम नमः शिवाय।